An implication of this is that it's impossible to have a ball resting completely still on your
so
car.
Shit. That See, I can do that.
At first, but it's actually not right what now. Gives you the control needed to balance the ball on your
this
roof.
This guy's actually dog shit.
Is air resistance even a thing in Rocket League? Yes. The ball has air resistance. The ball slows down in the air. That means there's air resistance, right? No, it doesn't. Yes, it does. What do you mean? If you shoot the ball is gonna slow down. Like, look. Oh my. I'll try and pinch it. The ball does go slower in the air. That's gravity. There's no air resistance in Rocket League. See, it gets slower. Right, watch. Does it get slower? Yeah, it does. Bro, I watched a rocket science video. I swear the game's got air resistance. So, final answer. There's no air resistance in Rocket League. There's none. That is the answer. Is that the correct answer? No? When there's air resistance, the ball would be curving when spinning. How'd you explain that one? Huh? Physics. I got you there, didn't I? Fucking hell. Imagine using Bing. Ask Jeeves. Is this it? God, that caught me off guard.
2, 1, 0, 0, all engine running.
You guys voted on Twitter and Ball Physics won the poll.
This guy's
so
German.
Let's talk this topic
he must be smart.
First, we need to talk about units. The engine uses a custom unit to measure distance, the Unreal unit. You already know this unit from your camera settings. 100 height means that the camera is 100 Unreal units above the ground. If you don't want to get spoiled
so
about
Unreal
the rocket
door, is a measurement.
You might want to stop watching now because I'm about to reveal the size conversion that the game uses.
See.
All right. One Unreal unit is equal to 1 centimeter. I will be using the Unreal unit. One Unreal.
So, how many Unreal units is your dick size?
unit is equal to 1 centimeter.
Oh my.
I will be using the Unreal units in this video because the values make the most sense, but I'll put conversions on screen whenever possible.
Good one.
There are some 2300 Unreal units a second and
83 km/h. What? This fucking mixed number? No, that's not
for the
a
ball, it's 6,000 Unreal.
What is km over h? Kilometers per hour? Ah, no. No. It's kmh minus 1.
Units.
He's writing it the wrong way. If you're a real physics guy, then you would know that you do kmh minus 1. Or is it minus 2? You know what I mean? If you're doing physics right, you don't do per, that's for noobs. You do the...
second. The maximum spin
it's
the
same,
ball can have...
but the proper way to do it...
is also limited to 60 RPM or 1 full turn per second.
A vacuum is no air pressure. So it's like, it's actually like being... So if you went to space right, and you were floating around, then you're in a vacuum.
30 Unreal units per second squared. Because the ball can't spin faster
yes,
than one
bro,
round per second, it's not fast
smart.
Enough to roll without sliding Ooh. Unless the ball moves at a speed of less than one time its parameter per second. All the cars have a separate hitbox in the shape of a rectangular cuboid. The slope of the octane is just for the looks and doesn't do anything to the ball. That's not all though. Rocket League has another anomaly that you wouldn't expect. In real physics, when the ball bounces on a surface like the car's roof, there's something called the impact normal, which is perpendicular to the surface. The ball would behave the same way it would with the wall bounce, given the angle to the impact normal. In Rocket League, the impact normal isn't perpendicular to the surface. Instead, it points from the center of mass of the car to the point of impact.
Give me a fucking
This was done in order to make the hits more consistent.
Epiphany,
the real-world impact normal changes drastically on an edge, which would make those hits almost unpredictable. What does that mean for the ball, though? A real-life object where every impact normal points from the center of mass to the surface is a sphere. Given an impact point on the car, we can extrapolate the position on a virtual sphere and predict the bounce based on that.
What?
We can extrapolate the position on a virtual sphere and predict the bounce based on that. Essentially, it becomes a game of pool, with the only difference being
that not all the balls are the same Jack, size welcome,
and
bro.
The car is 10 times the weight of the ball. An implication of this is that it's impossible to have a ball resting completely still on your car.
Bullshit.
That might seem bad at
bullshit.
First, but it's actually what gives you the control needed to balance the ball on your roof.
You can do it with backers mod. In fact, you can do it with a backers mod. I'll show you. Watch and learn, ladies and gentlemen. This isn't without backers mod. Now, I don't know if you can actually do this at the start of the game or not, or everyone just sucked. Right, watch and learn, guys. This is physics with Scrub. Wait. Go on. Go on. Come on, you little fucking cunt. Come on! Boom! No. I can do it, I can do it! No! Come on! What do you mean? Easier to do on up. Funniest shit I've read all week. And you were calling me a retard. I'm done. That's because I got a stick drift. I got a stick drift. Doesn't count.
An implication of this is that it's impossible to have a ball resting completely still on your
car.
This
guy's so shit. See, I can do that.
At first, but it's actually what gives you the control needed to balance the ball on your roof.
This guy's actually dog shit. The conclusion that we can draw is that there is no air resistance in Rocket League, because if there was air resistance, then the ball would spin. So that means it's only gravity.